So first of all, we are seeing that we have already done all these things, such as what we have done. We have done this DFT. We have done already. So now, with the help of this DFT already done. So now DFT mainly we are mainly two partition are there. One is low pass filter is there. That means only low frequency will pass, and high pass filter is there. That means only high frequency will pass. Low frequency, low will be crossed. That means low will not go from here. And here also high will be crossed. So high cannot able to move away from it. So there is again a subdivision of this one. So again a subdivision means that one is ideal low power, and this one is ideal. I have said on the last day that this low pass filter or high pass filter, all of them have three parts, again subdivided. One is Butterworth, one is ideal, and another one is Gaussian. Okay, in both the parts we have the same things. Ideal is there, Butterworth is there, and Gaussian is there. So what we will see here, this one is a very smaller video. So here actually we are smoothening the things, and here actually we are sharpening the things, since high frequency are being passed. So first of all, ideal low pass filter, what will happen? They are saying that DUV actually means the distance from the point U and V, any two points within the region, any two points are there. So that must be lesser. Okay, so how it will occur? So, since we have said that in the last day, if you can remember about it, that we are multiplying this one HUV. So let me show it from here. Just moving a little fast forward. So Fourier transform we have get, Fourier spectra we have get, and we are actually seeing that ideal how this is being converted. So here what we have done, we have an FUV function and then a filter function HUV into FUV. HUV means a filter function. So actually this filter portion is being denoted by here. That means whatever we have an image, first we have an image in FXY that has been Fourier transformed, it is converted into FUV, then it is again converted back to this filter function HUV. So HUV multiplied with FUV, then again they are converting to inverse Fourier transform, and then after post processing we are getting the value GXY, an enhanced image. Actually this portion we are seeing, we are now seeing this one, such as this HUV part has been shown. So HUV part consists of, here what we are seeing here, here HUV, first of all we have an ideal filter. In ideal filter we will take 1 if the value is less than D0, and if the value is greater than DUV is greater than D0, then it will have a value of 0. That means actually here we are seeing a if we are taking a wave, this is the wave, like this the wave is going on. So a D0 is a point from where a slicing has been done. Okay, a slicing has been done. So that what matters means that we have seen that actually a frequency, actually what we denote in frequency domain, it cuts the it mainly consists, the wave consists of many frequencies. So we will do that D0, so we will do this frequency will be lesser, only the lesser, those frequency which are lesser under this D0, that means which frequencies are lesser, that is touching the D0, above portions will be cut down. Higher frequency will be cut down. Only the lower frequencies which are below this D0 will have a value of 1, and other will have a value of 0. Okay, so higher frequencies will cut down and the lower frequencies will remain. In the similar manner, just as we are doing for the high pass filter, the opposite thing is occurring. here what it is occurring, it is occurring actually zero is occurring here, and the reverse portion, that means which are higher that will pass, and those which are lower, that means less than d0, so at that time what is happening, we are putting them zero. Actually this is the ideal high pass filter. So both of them, so all these things, they have put the equation, they have done something such as fxy, if the value of fxy is m cross n, then an equation has been developed from this one. Actually the distance we are measuring between u and v, and on duv our d0 value has been denoted, that one is a non-negative value quantity. So this non-negative quantity must be lesser within that, if that one is lesser, values will be shown in this low pass filter, whereas in high pass filter this will be just the opposite. So one disadvantage occurs, that one is blurring of the edges will occur. We will see that blurring of the edges. I think we have some examples of it, so let me see afterwards. So Butterworth, another low pass filter, Butterworth low pass filter, what they have done, they have a, it also have an another equation, that is duv divided by d0 2 to the power n. okay, so 2 to the power n, same thing has been written here, but that thing is opposite. Okay, d0 has went upwards and duk uv, actually uv has been written downwards. So actually what will happen, if the value of this 2n, we know that if the value of this 2n will become very very much large, so it will become 1 by infinity. Okay, so if this one is 1 by infinity, actually the value of huv will become 0. It is almost like the ideal pass filter, but it has some advantages, that is we can able to define the edges here. Okay, edges means here the edges will be blurred, and this one will be, edges will be clear. And in at the last we have a Gaussian filter which removes the low frequency noise. Low frequency noise will be removed, any frequency if they are present, that means it is smoothening the thing, and this will remove the high frequency, total thing is not there, this will remove the high frequency noise. Okay, so these are the three, whatever we are seeing, that these are the three types of filters are there which are present within this image, that means after 2DFT. So what type of filters we can use in 2D, two dimensional DFT, so these are the filters we can use. We can use it in one dimensional DFT. So let us see some of the examples of these filters, such as we have an ideal low pass filter. So what will happen here, simply cut off the high frequency components that are specified, distance d0 from the origin, all the high pass filter will be cut down, all the high frequency components will be cut down. So huv is the actually the filter, and its value will be 1 if it is, as I have said beforehand also, from the pen file. So duv must be less than or equals to d0, at that time the value will be 1, that means for low frequency, and for higher frequency it will be 0. And since the image is m cross n, so actually from the distance, how as we consider x1 minus x y1 square and x2 minus and x2 y1 y2 square, so from there we can actually of this whole square we are getting square root of this one, the distance. So from that, if we are putting this m and n value in this equation of duv also, so where we are putting u and v are the values, such as x and x1 and x2, and m and n are the other values, so these are the things. So if we put, we will get this equation. So now let us see some of the examples, such as a low pass filter. So here is a low pass filter where the filter's radius are 5, 15, 30, 80 after Fourier transform, after Fourier spectrum being applied, what will be the output of those things, such as this one. So we will get, when the radius is 5, it is almost blurred out, and slowly slowly we are seeing that the blurring will become smaller as the radius will become, means the distance becomes smaller, larger. At that time, such as 230, at that time it will become so much higher that the original image can be seen directly. So these are the examples. And Butterworth, we have seen about the equation, that is DUV. So since this is a low pass filter, so we are dividing it with D0. And for different portions, we are seeing that if the value of n is 1, 2, 3 and 4, as we are increasing the value, and if it becomes almost nearly to the infinity, so at that time actually the thing will totally becomes infinity. 1 by infinity it will becomes, if it is infinity, then the value will become 0. This will become, total thing will become 0, equals to 0. So that is the thing, if the number of n becomes larger, at that time the low pass filter will, almost this Butterworth low pass filter will act almost similar to the what we called here ideal low pass filter. So similarly here also we have seen almost similar type of the things are being shown here. Okay, some disadvantage here, we can get the edges also very well. So result has been shown in a different manner. And here is a Gaussian low pass filter. Here also we have seen that d square uv minus d square uv 2d0 square. So you have to remember only the equations that may be needed. So Gaussian filters, low pass filter has been given, high pass filter has been given. This one is low, this one is high. And then corresponding high pass spatial filters, and which we have read already, has been shown here. So actually what is the functionality, here also we will see the result in a similar manner. Okay, so low pass filter, three types of low pass filter are being compared. Here it is 15, here it is 15, and here it is 15, where the radius are 15, but all the low pass filter. So here we are getting the degraded image. Actually here these two parts we are getting different images. So actually this is the thing. So a low pass Gaussian filter is used to connect broken text, such as this here, maybe some, if we enlarge it and see, that we will see some broken text is there. With the help of Gaussian, we can just little blurring has been applied, and almost this broken text has been removed. So this is the function of the low pass filter. And another low pass filter is that, here low pass filters used to remove blemish in the photography. So if it is so much blemish, but that means if it is, means contrast is very much more, a blurry effect will be there, a smoothing effect will be there. Okay, so now this low pass filter has been continued, so we do not have to need about this one. There we comes to the high pass, ideal high pass filter. Just it acts as a reverse, and here we are detecting the edges only. Okay, when it is 15, the edges are very much clear, and when the pass filtering radius becomes 30, 80, it becomes more diminished. Okay, so this is, here also we have the same thing, but here the opposite thing we have, D0 by DUV we have, whereas in the Butterworth filter, if we see, go to move to that one, just DUV by D0, and here we have, just let me come to the point, D0 by DUV, just the opposite one. Okay, so these are the things. So now thereafter high pass filter comparison has been given here. So this one is ideal, one is Butterworth, one is Gaussian. So from there high pass filter actually of 15, all of them are there. That here we will, here we are seeing that it is much more edges are getting out, but here actually a smoothing effect is also present. So these are the examples mainly for all these things which we are called Fourier transformation.